In the previous session, we have seen a very good application of the axiom of completeness. That was the nested interval property in the set of all real numbers. The property precisely stated the following. Suppose that we have a sequence of closed intervals i1, i2, etc. such that i1 contains, i2 contains, etc. That means i1 contains i2 as a subset of it, i2 contains i3 as a subset of it, etc. So in that case, if we take the intersection of all these closed intervals, that is intersection I from 1 to n ii, then we get that intersection to be non-empty. This is what the nested interval property says. Now we are going to see another important result in real analysis, and that is known as the Archimedean principle. The Archimedean property or Archimedean principle in its simplest form says that the set of all natural numbers is not bounded in the set of all real numbers. We know that the set of all natural numbers is of course bounded below, because 1 is a lower bound for that, and any number less than or equal to 1 is going to be a lower bound for the set of all natural numbers in the set of all real numbers. Therefore, it's not bounded above can happen only if it's not bounded above. What is meant by saying that the set of all natural numbers is bounded above in R? That means that we can find a fixed real number X in such a way that for any natural number, this X will act as a ceiling. That means N is less than or equal to X for any N. If this is not true, that is what the Archimedean property says is, if this is not true, that means that whatever X we are choosing, that X is going to be less than some natural number. That means no X can be greater than or equal to every natural number, or above any natural number, above any real number, we can find a natural number. This is the statement of the Archimedean property, and we are going to rigorously prove it now. The precise statement of the Archimedean property is the following. Given any real number X, we can find a natural number N such that N is greater than X. That means above every real number, there exists at least one natural number. So we are going to prove this using the axiom of completeness. So our proof, we are starting like this. This statement basically says that whatever X we choose, that is not going to be an upper bound for the set of all natural numbers. On the contrary, we will assume and see what happens if we take some X to be an upper bound. That means, suppose that there exists an X such that X is greater than or equal to every N. So suppose on the contrary that there exists some X in R such that X is or N is less than or equal to X for any N in capital N. So this means that the set of natural numbers is bounded above, that is N is bounded above. If N is bounded above, this is a bounded above subset of the set of real numbers. Therefore, by the axiom of completeness, N has a supremum in R. So since it's bounded above, there must be a supremum for N in R. Call that supremum to be alpha. So now we have alpha a supremum of N. Of course, we have already proved that alpha, if supremum exists, then it's going to be unique. Therefore, we are assuming that alpha is the supremum of N. But we know that there is a property of the supremum. If alpha is the supremum, any number less than alpha cannot be an upper bound for N. Therefore, alpha minus 1 is not an upper bound for N. So this means that if alpha minus 1 is not an upper bound, that means that there exists at least one element in the set of all natural numbers that is greater than alpha minus 1. Therefore, there exists some m belongs to natural numbers such that alpha minus 1 is less than m because it's not an upper bound. But then alpha less than m plus 1. But where is m? This m is in n, and the set of all natural numbers satisfies the property that if some number is there, some element is there, that element plus 1 is also there. Therefore, this belongs to n. But according to the assumption, alpha is the supremum of n. But alpha is equal to supremum of n implies that alpha must be an upper bound for all the elements in m. Therefore, alpha is greater than or equal to m plus 1. But how can these two together happen? So we are getting here alpha less than m plus 1, alpha greater than or equal to m plus 1. This is a contradiction. So why did this contradiction happen? This contradiction happened because we assumed we found a supremum for n, but we found supremum for n because we assumed that the set of all natural numbers is bounded above. So set of all natural numbers is bounded above, we assume that means that we assume that there is an x such that x is greater than or equal to every n. So if that is not true, then what is going to be true? Whatever x we choose, there exists one n such that that x is going to be less than m or n is going to be greater than x. So the statement we claimed we have proved completely, that is, given any x in R, there x is a natural number satisfying n greater than x. Now we will make one more statement in connection with what we just spoke. So our second statement is the following. The second statement is the following. Given any positive real number y, we can find a natural number such that the reciprocal of that natural number is less than the taken positive number. Or in other words, just see that 1 by n is greater than 0. Or in other words, between 0 and y greater than 0, there exists a 1 by n where n belongs to natural numbers. This is what the statement says. Between 0 and any positive integer, we can find a 1 by n. Or if we keep on choosing y to be smaller and smaller, still we can find 1 by n between 0 and that number. Therefore, 1 by n's are very, very close to 0. Close to 0, we can find any, at least one 1 by n we can always find. The proof of this statement is very simple and actually follows from the previous statement. What we assumed previously, we proved previously that this is statement 1, given x belongs to R, there exists n natural number such that x is less than n. So instead of x, if we choose 1 by y, since y is greater than 0, 1 by y is also greater than 0, what will happen? Put x is equal to 1 by y, therefore 1 by y less than n, there exists such an n. And after that, if we multiply, if we just take the reciprocals, what we get is 1 by n less than, this is what precisely we want. So we verified that between 0 and y, where y is positive, there exists is one natural number n such that 1 by n lies between this 0 and y. And we call both these statements together as the Archimedean property. In fact, the first statement actually implies the second one. And what about, can we say that the second one implies the first one? This is a question for you to think. In that case, if the second one implies the first one also, we can consider both to be equivalent.